More than ever, we realize how precious this freedom is. This is not going to be a very cheerful episode of Rijksmuseum Unlocked. The collection of the Rijksmuseum is full of objects and works of art that show the dark and more unpleasant side of human nature. There's war and violence everywhere. On paintings, we see homicide, sexual assault and rape, beheadings, huge naval battles, conquest and invasions, and even political murders. Maybe we are inclined to take the violence of past centuries for granted. But when it comes close, when stories get personal, it becomes more and more ominous, and it hits us where it hurts. I am Ludo van Halem, curator of 20th century art at the Rijksmuseum. We pick up the chain of violence with this aircraft. It's about 100 years old and one of the biggest objects in the collection. It looks quite innocent with its elegant and streamlined design, but its shiny appearance is quite deceptive. Actually, this was meant to be a murder machine. Machine guns stuck through these tiny holes in the hood, and they remind us that this originally was a lethal weapon. It's called the FK-23, and this refers to its designer, Fritz Kohlhoven. He was one of those optimistic pioneers of the early days of aviation. He built this airplane for the British Air Force in the First World War. And after this war, he returned to the Netherlands to start his own factory for civilian and military airplanes. But when World War II broke out, his factory, located at an airport in Rotterdam, was swept away by German bombs. Winners can become losers, but losers can also become survivors. This applies to Isabel Wachenheimer, who survived the Holocaust. Her camp coat is the silent witness of her terrible sufferings. Isabel's family took refuge in the Netherlands in the 1930s. But in 1943, this Jewish family was rounded up in one of those infamous razzias in Amsterdam, and Isabel was only 15 years old. The family was taken to the Auschwitz concentration camp, where Isabel's parents were taken away to the gas chambers and murdered. Isabel herself was sent to a forced labor camp. After the liberation in May 1945, she was hospitalized in Switzerland, ill, mistreated, and devastated. She was one of the survivors of a genocide on a scale and of a cruelty that's beyond imagination. To remember her sufferings, she kept her camp coat all her life. This sculpture also reminds us of violent events. It's the original design of the destroyed city, the monument that commemorates the devastating bombing of the city center of Rotterdam in May 1940. The city is represented as a human being with a hole where its heart should be. Man without a heart, who throws his arms in the air with a cry of agony and despair. Ossip Zadkine executed this sculpture 6 meters high in bronze, commissioned by the Bijenkorf department store. It was unveiled in 1953, but the Bijenkorf only made itself known as its donor in 1978. Only then it appeared that the sculpture was also a commemoration of the violence this Jewish company had suffered from in the Second World War. In 1964, Shinkichi Tajiri traveled back from the Netherlands to the United States. He was born in Los Angeles and he had married a Dutch woman. During an artist's residency in Minneapolis, he made several sculptures he appropriately called Made in USA, and this is the largest one. As the child of Japanese immigrants, Tajiri had felt what oppression based on race had meant, and as a soldier in the Second World War, he had experienced violence firsthand. This sculpture is a murder machine, like the airplane. But not a real one, but one from imagination. It's a haunting image straight from a science fiction movie. A cannon on insect legs with a mohawk with the stripes of the American flag. It's not the glorification of violence, but the artist's vision of its presence in life. In 1964, American society was caught in a spiral of violence. President Lyndon Johnson had signed the Civil Rights Act, but that didn't mean the fight for racial integration had been won. Black Americans still suffered from white violence, oppression, and exclusion. Let's jump to present day. On May 25, George Floyd was killed by police violence in Minneapolis, the same city where Tajiri made his sculpture. The civil rights movement of the 1950s and 1960s is now followed up by the Black Lives Matter movement. All those images of violence in the collection of the Rijksmuseum are not simply just there because violence is part of human nature. We show them because violence is deeply connected with inequity, oppression, and discrimination. And that can deprive us from the freedom of speech, of thought, and of education. More than ever, we realize how precious this freedom is.